Hey everyone, welcome back to Snackable Growth. Today, I want to talk about resilience and how we can better tap into this incredible power that lives within all of us. For me, faking resilience like it's my job has given me the courage to pursue the things that are competitive, scary, and often uncertain. Exhibit A, starting a YouTube channel. In this video, we'll hit on first what resilience is, second, why it's the key to literally everything, and finally, three ways that you can work on building resilience in your life. Ready? Let's do this. So first, resilience is our capacity to recover from difficulties in our life. It's our ability to time and time again endure, and to persist in the precise moments when it's the most difficult to. I'm convinced that resilience is literally the key to everything. It's your tool for how you face fear. It's your tool for how you manage time. And most of all, it bridges the gap between just dipping your toes into something and actually diving in headfirst to commit to it. And at the end of the day, when you think about anything that you're trying to do in your life, resilience will have the greatest impact on whether or not you achieve it. So, how do we milk this magical trait for all that it's worth? Or to put it more nicely, how do we build our resilience? Here are the three tips that have been working for me. First, fantasize. I know this is kind of an odd choice of word, but bear with me. We can persist through resilience the more clearly we can envision our greatness. I found that while it's super intimidating to picture myself as some incredibly successful author, it's also crystallized in my mind as something that I deeply want. By constantly envisioning it, constantly fantasizing about it, it's only made me want it more. And it's made me want it enough to actually overcome my fear to just start pursuing it. I found the resilience to actually pursue it after realizing the delight in fantasizing about it. My second tip for building your resilience is to act like a kid. Kids are not only great at imagination and fantasy, but they're also great at execution and all the fumbles that come with it. In particular, kids have this wonderful trait that I deeply admire. They are okay with the gap that exists in anything that we try to do, the gap between our tastes and our talents. Kids are flexible and forgiving of that delta, but as adults, we are super frustrated by that gap. And so as a result, we ditch the doodle because we're so aware of what a great drawing looks like. So if you want to be resilient, start by doing the thing, even if it doesn't meet your standards. Don't sacrifice a good something for a perfect nothing. And in short, save the self-doubt for the cranky adults and just start acting like a kid. My third and final tip to shape your resilience is to generate enthusiasm. People that are resilient don't have any less self-doubt than the rest of us normal people. Instead, they just generate enthusiasm in spite of it. They generate enthusiasm to fight it. And that means that resilience isn't some epic divine gift. It's really just the simple stuff. It's laughing at your own insecurities. It's smiling and shrugging when things go awry. When all you have to lose is pride, enthusiasm will recognize that that's not a good enough reason, and it will help keep you resilient. That's all from me today. I really hope that you found these useful in thinking about the role resilience can play in your life. To be clear, I certainly haven't mastered it, but making videos like this one is my own small act in practicing it. Let me know your thoughts in the comments, and if you subscribe, you will certainly only help my resilience. Hope to see you next time on Snackable Growth.